Yeah, I was going to say, before we talk about Beamer's impact right now, because obviously you were one of the top, you know, players, alumni, whatever, that was advocating for Shane Beamer to get the job, and there were a ton of you guys. I want to go back to while you were at South Carolina, 08 to 11. Obviously, Shane Beamer was there. I'm assuming he was one of the lead guys in recruiting you, correct? I mean, how involved was he in your recruitment? I'll ask you that first.
He was not there when he was He was not there. No.
Okay. Well, talk about then when you were on campus. Obviously, again, this is a guy you developed a relationship with, and he was coaching. I believe it was on the defensive side of the ball, defensive backs, and the special teams coordinator. And he did become the recruiting coordinator for you guys. But obviously, you were around this guy a lot. Just your memories from Shane Beamer. And obviously, the word that was thrown around a lot in the coaching search was culture, getting the culture back into Columbia. And I was able to fortunate to talk with your former teammate DJ Swearinger. He talked about it. They talked about reestablishing the standard in Columbia. But just talk about the type of guy he is, the type of coach he is. What do you remember specifically from when you were Columbia Shane Beamer, the impression he left on you?
Just the first thing that, you know, I've had this question asked me, you know, a few times, and the one word that I can describe him with is just passion. He is a very passionate dude. And he loves Columbia, man. He still has an 843, you know, area code number. And, I mean, he's high energy, high urgency guy. You know, he comes from a lineage of a Hall of Fame coach. And, you know, he loves Columbia, man. He loves Gamecock football. And, you know, there's a reason that he's here and why he got the job, you know, without having any sort of coordinator or head coaching experience. And I know a lot of people, you know, were kind of giving him shit about that. But, dude, like that, the former players that know this guy, we all advocated for him, and there's a reason he's where he's at. And I'm looking forward to it. I can't freaking wait. I was actually texting with him, you know, back and forth today. And I honestly can't wait. I'm super ecstatic about it. I think he's going to bring a lot of urgency, a lot of energy back into the program.
For sure. Like I said, that word culture and getting the standard back, that was the common theme. And I said this a lot, and you can speak to this a lot more than I can, but I said to people that I think in a lot of different coaching searches, maybe that wouldn't be the most important thing, right? But I think in this one, this is a unique situation because you see kind of, and it's with all due respect to the previous staff and what they did, whatever, you saw that kind of fall off. You saw, you know, let's just call it for what it is, players going at fans, going at coaches, and it just became a swirling shitstorm of divisiveness. Talk about specifically, because again, people speak to that a lot, but I want fans to understand and get your take and perspective on it. The culture that we all talk about, Beamer getting that culture back and setting that standard. Explain that. Like, what do you specifically mean when you say that?
He is a player's coach first. Mm-hmm. You know, he's not going to have these coaches. Well, he may not. I don't know. But, he was there with Spurrier. He saw Coach Spurrier, how he treated his staff. He saw how he treated the players. I mean, you know, excluding me because Spurrier fucking hated me. So that's a different story. But he saw how he interacted with all the other players. And dude, I mean, you let these guys go. You let they have other lives, you know, outside of football. And when you are locked in at football all the time, you just get burned out. I mean, that's just call it what it is. And I think, you know, having him see that and see how Coach Spurrier kind of approached the coaching staff and their families, the players and their families, that's how it's got to be. You got to have that balance. And I think he's going to thrive at it, man. It's going to be a lot different. There's some other stuff that, you know, I could tell you off record as far as some of the former players, you know, with this past administration, you could say, but yeah, I mean, I feel like it's going to be a relief. It's going to be a little breath of fresh air. And, you know, I think he's going to thrive, man.